have given a set as 1, 2, 3, and you want to form a number out of this set. You want to form a number out of this set. Then the possible permutations here are 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2, then 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1. That means total 6 permutations are possible. Or we write this as at the first place we have 3 different options, at second place we have 2 different options, at third place we have 1 option without a repetition. So this total number of permutations are 6. Total number of permutations are 6. Okay, but here we have been asked to choose a number or arrange these digits to form a number. So if I change this question to select digits to form a lottery digits. Okay, so in lottery digits, what happens? Irrespective of the order, if you have these digits in your lottery number, if you have these 3 digits in your lottery number, you get a prize. Okay, for example, say if your lottery number is 5, 2, 1, 6, 9, 3. Okay, now you just need to check if the lottery number is 1, 2, 3. If lottery number is 1, 2, 3, you need to check whether 1 is in your lottery number or not, 2 is in your lottery number or not, or 3 is in your lottery number or not. So if these 3 digits are there, then you can claim the prize. You can claim the prize. So here, the order is not an important issue. The order is not an important issue. So if order is not important, then number of combinations will be this only. So this will be counted as 1. Irrespective of their order, digit 1, 2, 3 is selected. Digit 1, 2, 3 is selected. So if you write this as 3, 2, 1, then also, what is the selection? Selection is of digit 1, 2 and 3. 1, 2 and 3. So here, order is not an important issue. And if order is not an important issue, we are getting only one option as 1. So this formula we write as a permutation formula as NPR equals to N factorial divided by N minus R factorial. In this example, N equals to 3, that we have 3 digits given. An arrangement that we have been asked is a 3. So this will become equals to 3 factorial equals to 6. But if we try to write the formula for combination NCR equals to, with the help of the permutation, so this is N factorial divided by N minus R factorial, and answer we should get as a 1. So what is required to be written at the denominator? You require to write the R factorial here. So if we write this formula, then what will happen? This is 3 factorial divided by 0 factorial. 3 minus 3 is 0 factorial divided by 3 factorial. So this will be equals to 1. Or let us take some other example. Here N equals to say 6. N equals to 6, R equals to 3. That means N is equal to, we have given the set as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And we have been asked to select any 3 digits. Okay, so what formula we will write for NCR with respect to NPR? So this is N factorial divided by N minus R factorial. And we should also divide it by the number of arrangements in permutations. The arrangements are important. Okay, so that's why we should divide the arrangements, or we should remove the arrangements from the permutation. Because in combination, the arrangements are not at all important, or the order is not at all important. We have to just select 3 digits. We have to just select 3 digits out of this, out of the 6 digits. So it can be any digits. let me, it may be 4, 5, 6. So if you have selected 4, 5, 6, or if you have selected 6, 5, 4, so this selection and this selection is the same. This selection and this selection is the same. We have to just select the 3 digits. We don't want to form any number out of this or anything like that. So the order is not important. So these arrangements we will have to remove, that are 5, 6, 4. These arrangements we will have to remove from the permutation. So to remove the arrangements, we divide by the R factorial. We divide by the R factorial. So this answer will be N factorial, that is 6 factorial, divided by 6 minus 3 factorial into 3 factorial, or which will equal to 6 factorial divided by 3 factorial. Or this we can write as 6 factorial, we can write as 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial. So this 3 factorial, 3 factorial will get cancelled. This 3 factorial we can write as 3 into 2. So these are 3, 2s are 6, 2s are 4. So 4, 5 are 20. So 20 such combinations can be formed. And if we have solved it with the help of the permutations, then what answer we would have got? 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 factorial divided by 3 factorial. So this is cancelled. 6, 5, 3, 5, 4 are 20 equals to 120. So this is permutation. 120 is a permutation, 20 is a combination. Why permutation number is higher? Because these are counted as 3 different numbers. These are counted as 3 different numbers in a permutation. But these are the single selection in the combination. This is the single selection. You are selecting digits as 4, 5, 6, irrespective of its order. Irrespective of its order. So order is not important in the combination. So that's why in permutation formula, we are dividing or we are removing the arrangements. We are removing the arrangements. So this R factorial stands for, it is used for removing arrangements from permutation. Remove arrangements from the permutation. Okay, so combination is quite simple as compared to a permutation. We have to just remove the arrangements from the permutation. Okay, let us understand some examples and then we will stop in today's lecture. Okay, let us take first example as a committee. Of ISA. Committee of 3 students of ISA is to be formed. Is to be formed with is to be formed with 2 girls and 1 boy out of 50 girls and 30 boys. In how many ways? This can be done. Okay, what is the question? We have to form a committee of ISA. ISA stands for the Information Technology Engineering Students Association. Okay, so we have this kind of the committee in our department. And then while forming this committee, we used to have 3 positions, one for the president, one for the secretary, and one for the treasurer. President, secretary, and treasurer. Okay, so the same committee we have to form. Yeah, but we want to form this committee with the help of two girl students as majority of the girl students in the class and one boy student out of 30 boy students. Okay, so in how many ways this can be done? So total number of students are 80. Total number of students are 80. So how many options do we have to select a girls? So here n equals to 50. For example, say we are to select the girls first. Girls. So in girls, n equals to 50 and r equals to 2. In boys, n equals to 30 and r equals to R equals to 1. Okay, so the girls can be selected. Selection of girls will be NCR. NCR equals to 50C2. This is 50. And boys can be selected in NCR ways, that means 30C1. And the both are compulsory, that there should be 50 girls, we have to select 2 girls and 1 boy. So this and word have the importance. Whenever there is an and word, you have to multiply this. So this is a selection. So committee can be selected in this way. This is for girls and this is for boys. And both are compulsory, that 2 boys and 1 girl. 2 boys and 1 girl. So this is equals to 50C2. Now this you can write as 50 into 49 divided by 2. Am I correct? And this you can write as 30. Because 30 divided by, if you use the formula as NCR formula is n factorial divided by n minus r factorial into r factorial. So n minus r will be 30 minus 1, 29. Now let me write this in terms of the formula at the first term so that we will understand. Okay, so this is 50 factorial divided by 50 minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial. Am I correct? And this is 30 factorial divided by 30 minus 1 factorial into 1 factorial. Or this we can solve it as 50 into 49 into 48 factorial divided by 48 factorial into 2. This 2 factorial we can write as 2 into 1 or 2. Okay, one in the numerator or denominator multiplied by anything is not going to affect the result. So writing 1, or if you don't write 1, then also it is okay. So this will be removed. And here 30 into 29 factorial divided by 29 factorial into 1 factorial. So this 29 factorial will be removed. So this will become equals to 25 into 49 into 30. This 2 will divide this 50, so it will become 25 into 49 into 30. 1 factorial is always a 1. So this is your answer. In this many ways, you can select a committee of ESA out of 50 girl students and 30 boy students. Condition is you have to select 2 girls and 1 boy. 2 girls and 1 boy. So your order will not affect the result. So either you can select the first boy, or you can select X girl first and Y girl second, or you can select Y girl first and X girl second. So that order is not going to affect. You have to just form a committee. Let us take one more example. So these are the normal examples that you find in your aptitude examinations. Examples based on bag and ball, or example based on the cards, or example based on the playing cards or the dice. Okay, so these are the common examples, one of them that we will take. What is the number of quids? Of choosing, of, so whenever there is word as choose or select, that example is of the combination, and whenever there is word as arrange or form a number, form a name, then these kinds of the examples where you have the arrangements, certain conditions are given for the arrangements, in that case you can use the permutation. What is the number of ways of choosing? 4 cards from a pack of 52 clay playing cards. 4 cards from a pack of 52 playing cards. Question mark. In how many? In how many? Of these. First, 4 cards are of the same suit. 4 cards are of the, okay, so these kinds of the examples we are going to study in the probability also. Are of the same suit. Second, 4 cards belong to 4 different suits. 4 cards belong to 4 different suits. Third, 4 cards are all face cards. Then 2 are red and 2 are black. 4 is 2 are red and 2 are black. Cards are of the same color. Cards are of the same color. Cards are of the same color. Okay, so these are the 5 or 6 examples that you have to solve. So what is the number of ways of choosing 4 cards from the pack of 52 playing cards? Okay, so all of you are aware about the playing card suit. Am I correct? So how many types of cards in playing cards? So there are these kinds of the card. 2 are red, 1 is called as the first is diamond, second one is the
heart.
Then okay, now I don't remember the exact, instead of black I will use the white color. Third one is this kind of card. Do you know what this is called as in English? And one more is this kind of the card.
Spade.
This one is spade. This one is Daya and Heart. Okay, no one will forget this. Diamond. And this one is, does anyone remember what is this? Let us check. Playing card.
Sir, club, sir, club, club.
Club, club, yes. Exactly, it is a club. This is a club. So these are the four types of the playing cards. Okay, now how many cards are in each of the suit? So these are called as the suit of the card. The diamond suit, heart suit, club and a spade. So there are 13 cards of each type. Am I correct? Total cards are 52. So there are total 13 cards of each type. And these cards are numbered from 1 to 10. And then comes your jack, queen and the king. So these cards are numbered from 1 to 10, then jack, queen and the king. So this jack, queen and king are called as the face cards. These are called as the face cards. Am I correct? Okay, now how many total yes. face cards are there? So these face cards are 3 in each suit. So 3 of diamond, 3 of heart, 3 of club and 3 of spade. That means there are total 12 face cards.
13, sir.
Yes.
13
face cards. Face cards means jack, queen and king. So we will not count a joker here. Okay, so there are only 12 face cards. Only 12 face cards. Okay, now let us read our, okay, this much information is sufficient, I think, for playing cards.
13.
What, 13? Face cards are 13. How? Can you explain 13 face cards? As I know, there are
3 jacks. It will be 13.
Yes? Which one? 4 jack, 4 queen. 4 king. Apart from this, which is a face card? Yes, which one is 13th?
So that's the first one.
First one is not a face card. It is not a number card. Yes, is a number card. It is always counted as a number card. And if you count this, then it will become 16. But it is not 16. This is a yes, but it is a numbered card. It has a number 1. It has a number 1. And what kind of face is there on S card? Does it have a face?
Oh sir, not have any face.
It doesn't have any face. So let me show you the images. So these are all cards. Okay, so let us show you. Yes. So it doesn't have any face. It is just a numbered card. It is just a numbered card having the number 1. And face cards are? These are the face cards. Okay, it has included here in the face card, but actually when we are studying probability, permutation, combination at that time, we are considering these 3 as a face cards. A jack, queen and a king only. Okay, so remember this to avoid the confusion. S is not a face card. So total we have 12 face cards. And is there any other thing to remember here? How many red cards are there? Red cards?
13.
And red cards and black cards?
26.
And 26. Black cards. Okay, now this information is enough to solve. So first question is, what is the number of ways of choosing 4 cards from a pack of 52 playing cards? So we have to select any 4 cards out of 52. So there is no condition given here. So here n equals to 52, r equals to the selection. So how many we have to select? 4. So this is equals to
n. So 52 factorial.
52.
52 factorial upon 4 factors.
Yes. So this is 52 into 51. We will directly write this answer. 52 into 51 into 50 into 49. 52 minus 4 is 48.
Yes, sir.
So 48 factorial will be 8
cancelled. 4 factorial.
Divided by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, later you can find the exact answer for this. Now let us go for the next question. Four cards are of the same suit. Okay, let me write this question first. Four cards are of the same suit. Okay, now how you can select these four cards of the same suits? So these four cards can be of heart, or this four cards can be of diamond, or this four cards can be of club, or this four cards can be of spade. Okay, which word I am using every time? Four cards of type heart, or four cards of diamond, or four cards of club, or four cards of spade. Am I correct? We have to select a four cards.
Yes, sir.
And those should belong to the same suit, but they have not mentioned the exact suit, whether it should be red, or whether it should be green, or whether it should be whether it should be heart, diamond, club, or a spade. It is not mentioned, so we can have four different options. They can be either belong to a heart, or all four cards belong to a diamond, or all four cards belong to club, or all four cards belong to spade. And how this you can write? So four heart, this you can select
13 C4
ways. Am I correct? And if there is word or, this or is replaced with plus sign, and is replaced with multiplication, and or is replaced with a plus. This is 13 C4 plus 13 C4 plus 13 C4. Okay, now we can solve this by putting up the combination formula and getting the answer. Now next question is, four cards belong to four different suits. Four cards belong to four different suit. Okay, now how you can write this? So you should have one heart and one diamond and one club and one spade. Each card should belong to different suit. So to satisfy this, we should have one heart and one diamond and one club and one spade. So this you can write it as a
13 C1
sign.
Multiplication
is replaced with multiplication. So this is 13 C1 into 13 C1. Next example is, what is it? Third, R faced cards. Four are faced cards. So can you tell me answer for
12 C4?
It is 12 C4. Total of faced cards are 12, and you have to select four out of those. You have to select four out of those. So it is a 12 C4. So this you can solve by putting up the combination formula. Then next is, Two are red and two are black. So this will be 26 C2 and 26 C2. Am I correct? Two red and two black. And last is, cards are of the same color. Now tell me the answer for this cards. These four cards are of same color.
26 C4.
Is this the answer?
Plus.
2 into 26 C4.
Because these are for red or black. Four cards can be a red or four cards can be a black. So this is 26 C4 plus 26 C4. Okay, so with this we will stop for today's lecture. I have some urgent work to complete.